Hey VC, this is Carlos from As the Table Turns. I wanted to come on here and do another episode in my series or whatever in singers or vocalists. This is going to be the top five not best singers. Basically singers that aren't necessarily the best, and but they have something about them, about their voice, about the way that they sing things that is charming, that wins us over, you know, in the end. And so yeah, and this list is not going to be in order, because I don't know how you really vote on that, or have the worst sounding voice, you know. But there's some ones in here that I think most people will be able to agree on, and then there's going to be some that people may be angry at me that I have on this list. But we're going to start with who we're listening to right now, and that is Leon Russell. He has not necessarily this song here that we're listening to right now, but the voice that he or the song Song for You, especially when he sings that song, his voice is goes out of key, you know, and his voice is not the best for that song. And he has something about his voice and the way that he hits some of the notes that just doesn't sound that great, but for some reason he wins me over because he doesn't sound that great, because he doesn't sing it the best, because he doesn't have the best voice. And that song's coming up next. But this is this is the best of Leon Russell. Great songwriter, great musician, session musician. Next, we're going to go to, I'm not really going to put these in order. All right. Also, there's going to be some, and I might add in a couple more, but I'm going to give them kind of a disclaimer. This next person gets a disclaimer as well, and that's Johnny Cash. It's not that he doesn't have a good voice and he hits notes wrong or is out of key. But he has a very limited voice, and he sings things kind of the same way each time. So his limitation, you know, it's his voice limitation that it really puts him on this list. He has a great voice. I mean, everybody loves his voice and loves the cadence in which he sings and the phrasing that he uses when he sings. And the inflection that he gives and everything, but definitely not one of the best singers. Johnny Cash. Kurt Cobain. Especially in this. This is, I think, what puts him on that list, because I was going to put people like Lou Reed or Tom Waits on this, but they're not trying to sound the best. Their music isn't trying to go that way, right? So Lou Reed has a very, you know, not the best voice in the world either, you know, but he's also not trying to perform or go beyond his voice limitations. And this, Kurt Cobain is definitely going beyond his voice limitations, and screeching and kind of screaming and off key. But there's something endearing about it. There's something charming about it. And I think it's the fact that would never be a good singer. And I feel it brings me closer to him, because I'm able to go, okay, well, he's given it his all. He's a normal human and he's given it his all. And I think that's what kind of makes it amazing. Let's see here. Let's go with one. I mean, that was one people should have expected, I think. But this is another one that people should expect, is Bob Dylan. You know, a limited range as well in singing, and his nasal, whiny voice is an offender to a lot of people. So yeah, that's kind of why he's on this list, is not only his voice limitations, but also the whininess of his voice. I know that Tom Petty kind of has that same nasally thing too, but Tom Petty's actually a better singer, way better singer than Bob Dylan. So anyway, Bob Dylan. All right. Going along that whole nasally, I wonder if you guys can guess who's next. And it's not that I think he's even a better singer than Bob Dylan, and that is Neil Young. But once again, that nasally sound to his voice, it can get annoying. It can annoy people. I remember it annoying me. I didn't used to like Neil Young. But once again, listening to his voice, listening to the songs, listening to the words, listening to the great songwriting like Bob Dylan's and Neil Young's, it just makes you fall in love with them, right? And the fact that they have this kind of whiny, nasally sound to them, it's once again endearing and charming in that way, that makes you not only appreciate them as much as other singers, but sometimes you appreciate them even more. All right, this one may piss people off, and I love him. Let me see if I can get it out here. All right, and that is Graham Parsons. In this album, he's not too horrible, but he has a lot of help from Emmylou Harris. But he is definitely not the best singer. If you listen to some Flying Burrito Brothers songs, like Burrito Number 2, that song, Burrito Number 1, he is just it's just funny, you know. But once again, it's that thing where you feel like he's an amazing artist, his voice is not the best, there's no way that his voice is near the best. He can hit notes fine, but something about his voice, it's like he can't keep the note. He's unable to keep a note, hit for a long time. His voice kind of wavers. So anyway, once again, but very charming, you know, endearing, the fact that he, you know, gives it his all, right? Other people I was going to put on this list, then I kind of took off, but now I'm just going to mention them, almost like I mentioned Lou Reed. But, you know, Billie Holiday did not have a great vocal range. I believe it was only one octave, maybe two. She used her voice she could sing, she could hit notes. But she also, she hit notes, but she hit them in her own way. I think knew the limitations of her voice, and that's kind of what made her sing in her style that she does sing in. And that's awesome. So, Billie Holiday. This next one is, you know, a little hard for me because I love him, you know, and I think he's an amazing singer. And I love his voice. He's going to make some other lists of mine. But, that's Louis Armstrong. I think he was limited in his voice, in the fact that in his gravelly voice that he was able to sing with. He definitely had a limited voice, but what an amazing singer, right? So, Louis Armstrong. All right, that is my list for not that great a voice. They're not horrible voices, right? They're not bad voices, but it's just singers that, or people that tried to sing or wanted to be a musician, and maybe they were the only one in the band that had the best voice. Although Nirvana, you had, what's his face? Foo Fighters boy playing drums. He has a way better voice than Kurt Cobain. Yeah. That's my list. Let me know what you think in the comments. Come up with your own list, whatever you want to do. All right. See you later, VC. Bye.